Hello. Recently I stumbled upon this paper which it has been written just a few months back, and it was submitted in some journal, I guess this journal on astrophysics. So this paper is basically on using neural networks and especially convolutional neural networks for analyzing some cosmological scale image data, I guess. So let's just read through cosmological surveys. There is also the Sloan data set, which I think so it's open source, but yeah, cosmological surveys is like something that really is data driven. Yeah, so cosmological surveys aim at answering fundamental questions about universe, including nature of dark matter and reason of unexpected accelerated expansion of universe. In order to answer this question, two things are needed: data from observation, theoretical model that allows fast comparison. So it is trying to explain how all these simulations or modeling can cost millions of CPU hours. So yeah, in this paper they are proposing a deep learning paper. And just on the point of deep learning, just 2 days back, people from Canada and UK, they are the pioneers of making a few deep learning concepts. So they got the Turing Prize. So yeah, deep learning is coming into the mainstream research, even if someone likes it or not. So that's happening. So they are using deep learning model to map, to establish a mapping between 3D distribution in hydrodynamic simulations. So, this is about galaxy distribution. So I'm not exactly sure if it's about accretion or simulation of accretion, or it's just a visual map, 3D constructed map, maybe just three parameters constructed map. So yeah, we'll have to dive into the paper to exactly see what kind of mapping they are feeding into the neural network. So yeah, 3D distribution of hydrolytic simulation and its underlying dark matter distribution. So there have been quite a lot of papers trying to model dark matter distribution inside a galaxy. So mostly relying on basic laws of physics and accretion and the visual data and like various Messier object studies that have been conducted to see the various shapes of galaxy and like so on. So one of the major challenges in pursuit is the very high sparsity in predicted galaxy distribution. So there is a sparsity in galaxy distribution. So it's not like just a few templates that are just gathered and we get the output. Sparsity is a really big killer when it comes to deep learning. So yeah, to this end, we develop a two-phase CNN to generate fast galaxy catalogs. So yeah, just like any deep learning model, making catalogs, templates, or batches or patches. These are the like go-to thing. We just want to do like pattern recognition and. One of the way is to make some kind of catalogs or something. So they have made fast galaxy catalog. We have to see as to how they have made it and compare the result against standard cosmological technique. So yeah, the standard cosmological technique, there is no one technique. There are many approaches, as said in this theoretical model, like people make theoretical models and like that. Yeah, so we find our proposed approach either outperforms or is competitive. Okay, so yeah, deep learning is always at par, because we can always make huge data and mostly overfit models. So the thing that I want to see is the fast galaxy catalogs that they've taken fully labeled, and have they overfitted the model and something like that. Compared to common methods used in cosmology, our method provides a trade-off between time consumption and quality and accuracy of predicted simulation. So I don't know how they are assessing the accuracy and quality of simulation. We'll have to dive into the paper again to see that. So yeah, in combination with current and upcoming data from cosmological observation, as I said, Sloan or some more observatories are there which give nice observations about. They just track a few patches in the sky and give us lots of petabytes of data. So there is that spectrally rich petabytes of data. So our method has potential to answer fundamental questions with high accuracy. Okay, this last sentence is complete bullshit, but yeah, it's too over optimistic. Like, how can deep learning solve every problem? So that's that. Okay, so let's see, little bit about the authors. I think so they are from the US. So let me just see as the paper loads. So the paper is quite big, I'll just be skimming over it, but yeah, this paper, when I stumbled upon it, it was like a big thing, because last year I had planned to make a like a project on like studying a galaxy and doing some image processing, applying some image processing techniques like edge detection or contrast enhancement, and trying to find patterns in it. But yeah, I failed because I was just new to these concepts, and there was it was too overwhelming, and I had to learn a lot. Okay, so Carnegie Mellon Center for Computational Astrophysics. So yeah, the paper is sent from the Center for Computational Astrophysics, which is, I think so, in many institutes. So there is one at Princeton, there is one at CMU, there is one at Flattery Ron Institute. So we have already covered the abstract. Now let's all go into some of the things that I'm skeptic about. So like, have they overfitted a model, and how have they made the template, and like that. So let's dive into the boring part, which is the introduction. Yeah, so the introduction is talking about how the data set is huge. There are trillions of galaxies, and even if you want to train anything, it's like millions of hours. And even if you want to analyze something, it takes a lot of handcrafting and a lot of valuable time of a scientist's life. So it's always important that deep learning seeps into such areas where there is so much data that can be collected. Nowadays there are detectors being made which are going to collect more data. Previously we never had that also. So there is the advancement in the detector, and there is the advancement in the algorithm side also, and the computation side also. So they are talking about the simulation and how they are like assessing the quality accuracy in the simulation. So the formalism is the gravity only n-body simulation, and they are making a phase space distribution of massive particles. So that's the kind of simulation that they are doing. I won't go into the details, but I really want to go in the details of how they are implementing CNN. So they use CNN to perform a mapping from 3D matter field in n-body to galaxies in full hydrodynamic simulation. So there is a mapping. So mapping means they are trying to make some kind of a function approximation between the 3D matter field in the n-body simulation. So n-body, that's a classic way of doing any physics simulation. And for galaxies also, doing hydrodynamic, like expressing them as hydrodynamic equation, is also like a well-established approach theoretically. So yeah, they are evaluate the kind of accuracy that they're measuring is based on various statistics. So the hydrodynamic simulation, power spectrum, bispectrum, to verify the accuracy. And there is no benchmark, but I don't know how they will be comparing with the classical approach. I have to really see if there is some data people have made handcraftedly or something. So yeah, background about cosmology. Like, there is insane amount of confusion about the current state of the art theory. There really isn't. There is just too much of theory out there on cosmology, and we really know that none of the theory fits well, because we really don't have data to test against. So yeah, this paper is a step in the right direction, I think. So machine learning in cosmology. Oh, what a bold topic. Like, how can you apply machine learning in cosmology? Let's just see. Like, you have to do a lot of pre-processing. You just can't make an objective like machine learning in cosmology. So I think they must have done it, because they must be a well-established department. So CNN, like, it has been used for the last 5 years, I think. Like ImageNet competition, which Andrej Karpathy won in 2015. Since then, CNN has been like very, very good. So CNN helps estimate like visual tasks like image classification, detection, and segmentation. So now the simulation data that they're feeding in, they are trying to make some kind of models, machine learning models using all these normal CNN things. So the CNN terminology, ReLU, average pooling, batch normalization, and all that. So here is the snapshot of their simulation toolbox. So illustrious toolbox. So they have kept the redshift 0, zoom in visualization like that. And let's go to this page to see if what all simulation things they have kept as open source. So yeah, illustrious toolbox, I really haven't seen, but let's look at the results. So properties, so it's basically about hydrodynamic simulation, maybe many lot of things to toggle with. So yeah, it looks like an accurate way of simulation, simulating cosmological scale galaxy population, since there are like tons of papers published with it. But yeah, let's just check out the overview poster. So this simulation was made by a group of institutes, mostly American, MIT, CMU, and so on. And I also know the Space Telescope Institute. So yeah, mostly a collaborative effort. And this toolbox looks good. I'll make a future video if this toolbox is open source. So mostly I'll have to contact them if I want to ever use it. So let's get back. We were discussing about CNN jargon and cosmology and this illustrious simulation toolbox. So they have used extremely randomized trees. So this is like a classical approach, and a classical approach is really good because it's fully supervised, and we can it's better than CNN because we can really go through the data quite well. So they have used that thing, and they have used CNN, and they have modeled some parameters, so WM and sigma 8 cosmological parameters. So I really don't know what it exactly is. I have to go through the toolbox to really understand these parameters. So yeah, so this is, I think, so the classical approach, the similarity between kernel and Laplace approach inspired Ribley et al. To propose new peak counting scheme. So yeah, this is a classical approach. Now let's get on to the data. So what kind of data cube they are generating. So they are utilizing two types of simulation, hydrodynamic, gravitational hydrodynamic forces, and astrophysical process, and n-body. So this is all from the illustrious project. Let me just quickly go through reference 28. So introducing the illustrious project, it was made in 2014. Maybe this toolbox is its main focus is on finding the dark matter content and doing accurate hydrodynamic and gravitational simulation of galaxies. So the data, oh my god, it looks quite overwhelming to read it at first glance. But so yeah, they have made lots and lots of point like particles and distribution of all of them. They have also made a voxel, which is like 3D pixels, and they have made a kind of a grid. They have assigned some percentage for dark matter, some percentage for galaxies, and then the simulation, they have like Also set the parameters like redshift and the size of it, 2.3 megaparsec per hour. So that's the region size, and so on. So yeah, they have also arbitrarily chosen, I don't know arbitrarily or not, but the testing data which has to be kept, and all the relevant parameters that like we can extract out from the data. So yeah, the methods. So it's basically CNN at the end, but like no one exactly directly do CNN. They whenever there is a new application area where you want to implement CNN, you always do some other methods too. So like here they did extremely randomized trees. So that might be a established method. I don't know. So they have developed a two-phase architecture. So making an architecture is quite easy for CNN, but it always depends on the application. We really have to attune the network quite properly according to application. So that's why even though CNN and driverless cars are a thing, they still haven't been realized fully, because the application, if its scope is too hard, then CNN also needs to increase in complexity. So yeah, the two-phase architecture. There is a high sparsity, so 99.6% do not contain any galaxies. So yeah, maybe they must have done some pre-processing. Let's look into it. So what they have is they have broken the training into different processes. The first part is the classifier, which sees the absence and presence. So yeah, this is a quite a nice approach. First have a binary classifier and have a few layers or one layer for it, and then introduce some kind of weight correction equation. So yeah, okay, so this looks quite novel. So second phase of the CNN is using some kind of optimization on the remaining voxels to predict. Again, it's some kind of a binary prediction, I guess. The prediction is predicting dark matter or something, and galaxy content. I really don't know. So yeah, they have defined this loss and so on. So the training of both is done separately. So they must have done it separately. They must have got the output of the first and fed it to the as an input to the second phase. So the phase is generic. So they are trying to tell this is just a first step. So there's a lot of sophistication or complexity that can be added to this two-phase CNN network. So it looks quite basic. Input fed to a classifier, binary prediction, binary target, and a loss. Then the input is done to regression model, and then binary prediction, final prediction, and real target. So yeah, that's the model structure. Now, have they used pre-trained network? I have to see that. We now present different types of convolutional networks we tested with physical motivations and specific modifications to fit the problem. So yeah, so they have used UNet, which is a quite a popular net neural I think so parameters set of parameters which has been used in biomedical image segmentation. So they have used it, and then R2Net. So they have tried quite a few models. And inception net. So these are all the terms which are very well known in CNN, and they have also created some kind of filter bank, some kernel size. Now this thing, I'm finding it quite fishy, because the filter size is quite small, and they said the data is very sparse. So it's better if they take a bigger size. So it depends, like if they have done some kind of dimension transformation of the data afterwards, because it's not like this inputted a simulated, they must have inputted a simulated data directly to the neural network. They must have done some kind of basis transformation or dimensional transformation. So yeah, they have used the convolutional layers and basic activation functions and tested out the results. The results they have compared against the classical approach. So this is the Halo occupation distribution. So this is like common benchmark. So I really didn't know this benchmark. I have to look it up. So let's look it up first. So yeah, Halo occupation distribution is a benchmark for large scale structure of universe as clumps of dark matter. It provides a view on how galactic matter is distributed within each of the dark matter clumps. So so yeah, it's a classical way of seeing this problem in terms of just distributions. Okay, so our main goal is to, yeah, their main goal was to see, accurately predict the abundance and spatial distribution by using information from this 3D dark matter field. So yeah, the problem scope is quite wide. I'm seeing that, and there isn't like too many references. There is like things that they're taking from the other fields, like image segmentation and so on, but there is nothing solid basis which has made them to like just directly compare with the benchmark. So again, some this is a repeated information about how they have chosen the training samples and how they are comparing it up with HOD algorithm. And these are some of the results. These are the pretrained neural networks, the weights and the accuracy, and the recall precision. There's no need to specify these, but they have. So this paper is not solving very big problem, because there is the problem I think so can be quite wide, because this predicting the distribution, like this real-time prediction, because there might be some telescopes and they might have real-time data. So it might be better if there is some kind of real-time distribution model that can be made. So again, this is very basic way of seeing error, MSC error, and they have seen this PK versus, so they have varied some parameters and got some results. And this is the visualization of the slices. So this is this from the simulation, as we saw from illustrious some kind of fibrous kind of thing. And then after yeah, this is the prediction after the first phase, second phase model, and the last column is the HOD prediction. So single phase classifier. Okay, so yeah, we have to classify this thing and this thing, so they are quite same. So it is this method kind of match up with HOD. So this is another way of extracting information, and some kind of more statistics that you can do, that is 2-point correlation and power spectrum. So yeah, this is some extra statistics. I'll just breeze through it, but the basic gist of the paper is kind of like it's quite obvious. So the paper is trying to make a deep learning model, a two-phase deep learning model, and trying to compare with the HOD algorithm, which has been there for quite a few years. So let's see how old this method is. HOD. Okay, so let's just look at the conclusion. Yeah, okay, the training time before that. The model generates large volume of galaxy distribution, and it's flexible enough to generate excellent match to target from small to large scale. So yeah, the time isn't specified and the metrics aren't specified, but yeah, it's just the first way of training they have just did it for the first time. Yeah, so this works open several trees for future research, and there can be various problem statements like internal properties, stellar mass, star formation rate, metallicity. Okay, yeah, so at various stages of the universe formation. So yeah, they are addressing all the future work out here. So there is a lot of exciting work that can be done, and I am personally excited to get hand on this illustrious toolbox and try out a CNN network for myself. So yeah, let's just see if this paper is kind of becomes quite important and lots of useful studies can be made out of it. So this thing is at least 20 years old, the HOD algorithm is at least 20 years old, maybe more. So yeah, that's the overview of the paper. They have done the hyperparameter search and model configuration. Yeah, this is all quite obvious. They must have mostly done the training in Python library, I guess, and they must have used GPU to train. So let's see the code. Libraries for analyzing numerical simulation. Yeah, so this is a library. I have to I can make a separate video on it, but yeah, this library is used for numerical simulation. So yeah, they have used this library. I can try and make a separate video on how this simulated data we can make there's a lot of coding that goes into it. So like computing all this things that we get from the simulated data. So yeah, this thing looks interesting. Make 21 centimeter maps. So like this looks like cool. Yeah, so that's it. The paper is quite good, and I hope that I myself can implement and reproduce, and I hope that this research gets followed up, and there's a lot of things that might come up.